All right, this podcast is for basically CNT120, but also a review for CNT125 on data encapsulation. So let's jump right in here. Previously, we had talked about OSA model and the layers of the model. Well, what we want to talk about now is data encapsulation. The book will show you a picture that has, you know, all the layers with arrows connecting all the layers, kind of going every which way but loose, and it's really hard to picture what's going on. When they talk about data encapsulation, it's really a matter of how do we package data, move it across the network to a device on the other end, how do we package that up, send it so the receiver understands it? Well, that's data encapsulation. And think of this as packaging up, let's say you're going to ship cookies to a friend that lives in California. So you're going to pack cookies in a bag, you're going to put them in a box with packing peanuts, you're going to tape up the box, you're going to put the address label in the box, you're going to take it to the post office, and they're going to mail it. Well, since you did all that prep work, when it goes to the post office, they should be able to put it on a truck, carry it across the country, and get it to the right person because you have packaged it well. Well, the same thing applies for data. If I package my data well, it should be able to move through the network to my intended recipient, to the intended node, to the destination, and they should be able to open it up and read it and potentially reply to it. So let's look at this process, basically preparing data to be sent, and as it does, it's literally going to work its way down through the layers from source out to the wire, across the wire, and up to the other side, to the destination. So let's use an example of, I like to use the example of maybe doing an HTTP request of a web server. So I'm going to start off right off the bat with this. I'm going to pull up our Wireshark that we've looked at it a couple times. I'm going to start a packet capture, and I'm going to download a web page, and then we'll look at the packet capture and see kind of the stuff that these layers are talking about as we go. So let me start a new capture, and I will open a web page, or I'll load a web page. I'll do a capture start. Yep, that's fine. I'll open up my browser, and I'll download a new web page. Let's do something like Toyota.com or something like that. Toyota.com. And we'll open that web page. Here we go. Look at that. We're opening up a new web page. Yay! Okay. Now I'm going to go back to my Wireshark. I'm going to stop my Wireshark session. We'll stop that. We have like 7,500 packets. But as we're sending our data, let me scroll the whole way to the top up here. As we're sending our data, it's going to get packaged and prepared and sent from me to the destination a certain way. So if I look at one of these pieces of data, one of these packets, if you will, I'll see a header in here, transmission control protocol, IP protocol, Ethernet protocol. All these header fields are important for packaging the data and sending it to the destination. Let me close these up. We'll come back to this in a little bit. But that's what we're talking about. We're really talking about when I go to request something, the data has to be packaged in a certain way so the receiver understands it and can respond to it. So let's go back to our PowerPoint here, and let's go with first layer, application layer, top of the protocol stack. Because again, we're starting with sender down to the wire, across the wire to the recipient. So sender station, application layer, the first thing we're going to do is package up an HTTP request, if you will. Send a request to the web server of, hey, I'd like your web page. And that's going to drop down. So there's your application layer. I have an HTTP request. That's going to drop down to the presentation layer, which is going to format it the correct way. Hey, I'd like to get this web page from you. And the session layer is going to start opening the session to the other end. Hey, I'd like a data transfer. Let's open up the correct port numbers to make this happen. Okay, so the first couple layers, the top couple layers, the formatting doesn't look much different. It's just my HTTP request. So let me go back to my Wireshark real quick, and I'll look for my HTTP request. So I'm going to sort here real quick, and let's look for, let me scroll to the top, get my alphabet right. Here's a whole bunch of HTTPs right there. And let's scroll to one of these first ones. We'll look at just one of these HTTP requests. This is getting some sort of piece of our web page here. So let's just look at this one where we look at it. And here I'll see in my HTTP, this is a particular get. Hey, give me this particular piece of the web page. And this is formatted a certain way so the receiver knows what we're asking for. All right, so there's my HTTP request, if you will. All right, let's go back to our data encapsulation process. So these first three layers, top three layers, application, presentation, session, we usually refer to the data at this point as just simply data. Some books will call it application protocol data unit, then presentation protocol data unit, and then session protocol data unit. But generically speaking, these are just data at this point. We're just kind of formatting it in the right way that the receiver understands this as, hey, give me your web page. That's what it really amounts to. Well, as my data formatting, my encapsulation occurs, it's going to get passed down to my transport layer. The transport layer, as we start shipping data back and forth, we typically segment it. And when we do that, we will put a TCP header on that indicates this is piece 1 of 100, 2 of 100, 3 of 100, 4 of 100. And it's going to also contain some other information for reliability reasons. If you remember when we talked about the OSI model, TCP header is there for reliability. So it's going to contain things like sequence numbers, numbering the bytes, acknowledgement numbers, to say to the other end, hey, I got these first couple bytes, send me the next couple. Checksums, other things like that for all the reliability pieces that we need. So as this gets passed down, a TCP header is getting added to our HTTP data. And that is there for the reliability piece that we talked about before. So let's go look at our HTTP request again. I'm going to pull it open. And in here I will see, in addition to my HTTP header, there it is, there's my TCP header with all these fields in, including sequence numbers and acknowledgement numbers. And remember we talked about window size, how many bytes I can send at a time. There's my checksum to validate if it's good or not. Okay, so there is a whole bunch of pieces of my TCP header. And that is all there to, again, address this correctly, get it to the other end. The other end can read this and understand all this information. All right, so it gets passed down to the transport layer. We add the TCP header with all those fields in. Now we pass it down to the network layer. In the network layer, we're going to add another header. In the network layer header, we're going to add the IP address. The IP address is there so that routers in the network can pick up this piece of information, this packet, read it, and make a decision on it needs to go to this network versus this network. In a post office, somebody would pick up a package, read the zip code, and say, hey, it needs to go to the truck destined for Baltimore versus the truck headed for New York City. So the router is going to pick this up, read the IP address, and make a decision on, hey, I need to go to the 192 network versus the 207 network. So as the data moves down to the network layer is going to add an IP header. Okay? So let's go back and look at our HTTP request again. I'll look at my packet again. I'm going to close my TCP header, and I'm going to open the IP header. IP header now has in things like source address, source IP address, destination IP address. Where it's coming from, where it's going to. Source is where it's coming from, destination is where it's going to. So any router can pick this up and go, hey, I know where you're going. Read it and then pass it out to the correct port to get it to the right destination. And so that's all part of the IP header. And as I see now, as I look at my picture here, data for the top three layers, as it got to layer four, we call it a segment. As it gets to layer three now, we're calling it a packet. That's the proper name for it at that point. As this data moves down to layer two, we're now going to add on the Ethernet header. We're going to add the layer two header appropriate for that network. Well, most networks we're going to deal with are Ethernet, so we'll add an Ethernet header. If we were dealing with other networks in the world, it might actually be a token ring header or an AppleTalk header, that kind of thing. We're going to be passing it to an Ethernet network, so we're going to add an Ethernet header, which will contain the source and destination MAC address. Okay, so now, in addition to the IP header, we're going to add Ethernet header. And this is so things like switches can read it and make a decision on, hey, it goes out this port versus this port. And things like NICs can pick this up and go, hey, yeah, this is actually for me versus my neighbor computer. So at this point, we'll add an Ethernet header, and we'll call this thing a frame. That's what it's going to be called. So let's go back to our packet capture. Okay, I'm going to close my IP header. I'll open the Ethernet header. And in here, I'll see the source MAC address, where it's coming from, and the destination MAC address, where it's going to. So now any switch along the way could pick this up and go, oh, I know to pass you out port 10 versus port 12. So there is my Ethernet header, and this thing at this point, layer 2 data link layer, is going to be called a frame. The last thing to have happen is the data is actually converted into ones and zeros to be shipped across the media, my physical layer. Well, more times than not, it's going to get converted into ones and zeros and sent across a copper cable as voltage pulses. You know, pulse of voltage for one, no voltage pulse for zero. But if it goes across fiber, same thing will happen. It's ones and zeros, so as it gets sent across fiber, we have a pulse of light to represent one, lack of light to represent zero. So these are actually getting converted to ones and zeros, or what we would call bits. So at this layer, they're called bits. So these, the frames are getting converted to bits to send across our copper wire or fiber cable. This is one thing we can't show on our packet capture tool because it's all ones and zeros. So as far as I can go is my Ethernet header. All right. So there's my binary ones and zeros heading across the network. So there's my whole process. And this, at this point, all I've really done is taken my HTTP data and formatted it to send it across the network to a web server saying, hey, give me your website. The web server would receive this, open it up, just like it's receiving a box. It'd pick up the box and go, hey, is this for me? Yes. Tear it open, pull out the contents, which is going to be my HTTP request of give me your web page. It'll turn around, package up the response, it'll start packaging up the web page and start sending it to me in little pieces, little TCP segments, and start numbering them. Here's piece one, here's piece two, here's piece three, here's piece four. But it's going to turn around and repeat the same process of package it up, send it across the network to me. So this is kind of a back and forth thing. I package up my request, send it across the network to the server. The server opens it up, looks at it, and says, hey, I can respond to that. Packages up the response, send it across the network back to me. I open it up and go, hey, thanks a lot. And it's all happening through this data encapsulation process of formatting the data, breaking it into segments, adding IP addresses to the front to make it a packet, adding Ethernet addresses to the front to make it a frame, converting it to binary ones and zeros to send across the network. The receiver gets the ones and zeros, puts it into a frame, opens it up, looks at the packet, opens it up, gets the segment, starts putting them together and putting it back into data to display on a screen or whatever it happens to be. This is your data encapsulation process. And this is repeated back and forth, back and forth. And the header for each one of these contains data that layer needs. All right? So hopefully that makes a little more sense on the data encapsulation process. And if I go back one more time and look at our packet that we've captured off the network, we'll see there's the Ethernet header right there, IP header, TCP header, HTTP data. And what will look a little odd when you start looking at this now is you see Ethernet at the top and HTTP at the bottom. Well, as this packet came into the computer, the first thing it saw was the Ethernet frame, so it tore it off and printed it on the screen for me. Then it saw the IP header, tore that off, printed that on the screen. Then I saw the TCP header, tore that off, printed that on the screen. And the last thing it got was the HTTP data, so then it printed on the screen. So it almost looks backwards to you and I. But again, this is on the receiving end. This packet capture tool is working on the receiving end. Alrighty, so there's our data encapsulation process. And one more tidbit here on this. Again, as we do this encapsulation process, we refer to the data at each layer by a specific name. Data for the top three layers. Segment for layer 4 transport layer, packet for layer 3 network, frame for layer 2 data link, and bit for layer 1 physical. And of course there's a mnemonic for this where we can say don't send fill for bill. Don't for data, send for segment, fill for packet, for frame, and bill for bit. Don't send fill for bill. And that way we can remember our data segment packet frame bit in order. So there's our data encapsulation process. Hopefully that helped you out today.